Scripture reflection for Tuesday, August 24th. Today is the feast of St. Bartholomew, born at Cana of Galilee, who was brought to Jesus by the Apostle Philip. After the ascension of the Lord, he is said to have preached the gospel in India, where he was rewarded with the crown of martyrdom. Little is known about the Apostle, and perhaps he is just fine with that. It may resonate with what St. John the Baptist said. He would want Christ to increase and himself to decrease. The Bartholomew of Matthew, Mark, and Luke may describe the man known in the Gospel of John more correctly as Nathanael. Bartholomew is paired with Philip in some Gospel lists, which corresponds interestingly with Philip being an old friend of Nathanael in John's Gospel. Some scholars identify the Apostle Bartholomew with Nathanael, a solution supported by the fact that Bartholomew could be a surname, Bartholomai, which means the son of Tomai, and Nathanael a given name, Nathanael Bartholomew. After his appearance in the Gospel, Bartholomew first surfaces almost 300 years later in the works of Eusebius, a bishop and church historian who wrote about 300 AD, and relates a story about a Christian teacher traveling in India who is told that an apostle, presumably Bartholomew, had preached there long before him and had brought a Hebrew gospel with him. Equally, vague tradition have Bartholomew's evangelizing in Persia, Armenia, Mesopotamia, and Egypt. The details of his this death likewise dissipated in the flood of ancient history, and one tradition holds that he was flayed alive, a story reflected in Michelangelo's Last Judgment in the Sistine Chapel, which depicts Bartholomew holding his own skin. Because of this tradition, Bartholomew is the patron of Saint of Tanners. History holds that Bartholomew's relics are in the church named after him, in an island in Rome's Tiber River. What is remarkable about Bartholomew Nathanael, the apostle, is his simplicity when he said, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" And Jesus said about him, "Here is a true and Israelite in whom there is no deceit." And in his turn, Nathanael replied to Jesus, saying, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God, you are the King of Israel." The church conquered an imperfect world due to the heroic witnesses of the apostles. Blessings, Father Mosier.